set up our three pages in Webflow or whatever corresponding CMS platform you're using, we're here in MemberSpace because we need to set up our member pages and a member plan that will then connect to the newly created pages in Webflow. So if you don't have a MemberSpace account, you will need to set that up. We have a couple of links below for you on how to walk through setting up your account. Once you have your account set up, you're going to want to head to Member Pages. So under Member Pages, we need to add a couple protected member pages. Remember, we set up three different web pages and two of those are protected content. So the first one we're going to set up is for our new subscribers, confirming that they were actually subscribed to the newsletter. So if we come back over to Webflow, we'll see I've come here to the subscribe page and just clicked on the gear icon to ensure I get the correct slug. So I'm going to copy that, come back over to MemberSpace, and put that in here. This is the first page that they're going to see. So this is going to be immediately available to members, although if you were launching your newsletter in the future, you could have this open on a specific day and time. We're going to set up the member plan next, so let's focus right now on just getting this first member page done. Hit add now, and then we're going to go ahead and create one more member page, and this one will be for the actual newsletter, so the section that we were on before, the page that is previous newsletters. So we come to that gear icon, we'll grab that slug, come back over to member space, and put that one in here. Add now. Perfect. Now we have our member pages set up. We need to add a member plan. So that's what we're going to do next. Here under member plans, we're going to create a new member plan. Now it's important to remember for the purposes of this tutorial, we have not connected this account to Stripe. You will need to do that, and perhaps you've done that setting up your member space. If you haven't, take some time and go ahead and do that now. You'll see if you click on the recurring payment or any of the payment options, you'll get a link here to the setup guide and walk you through how to do that. Once you've done that, you can come back to this portion of the tutorial. I'm going to use the free no payment. So what we'll want to do here is say monthly newsletter. And now remember, the members will see this, so you're going to want to be sure it's descriptive. I've kept it simple, again, for demonstration purposes, but you're going to need to let them know what they're signing up for. You can add additional plan information if you'd like to give full details on the cost, all of the different types of payments and those things. I'm not going to do that for this tutorial. You can set up expiration times. Again, if this is a paid subscription, you'll have the ability to set the cost and how often the recurring payment will go through. Once you've done all that, we come to the member pages section. This is what we just set up. So we just set up our previous newsletters and subscribed, and we want all of the members to have access to this information. After the sign up, we're going to send our members to the subscribed link. So we'll need to do /subscribed. Here. After they've logged in, we want them to have access to the previous newsletters. So we'll come back over and just be sure we grab that slug. Back here. Perfect. So now when members sign up, they'll go straight to the subscription page, which will allow them to access their account. Or we also put a link in there to get to the login screen here, which is the previous newsletters. If they come right to the main page and log in, this will direct them straight to previous newsletters. If they come to visit the page and they are already logged into MemberSpace, they will go straight to their newsletter page. Here you'll want to make sure that this plan is on and public and go ahead and hit create this plan. Perfect. Now we have the monthly newsletter, so we just need to duplicate that same process. Remember, if this is a paid plan, you're going to want to select either multiple or recurring payment. This is the annual plan for us. Okay. Same thing, previous newsletters and subscribed. everything's enabled, and go ahead and create this plan. Perfect. So now we have a monthly plan and an annual plan for our newsletter. But we need to set that up with Webflow and tie everything together. To do that, we're going to go ahead and hit Get Sign Up Link and copy for our monthly newsletter. Come back into Webflow to our main newsletter page. And here under the Subscribed button, we're going to go ahead and drop in a link. And then for our annual plan, we're going to come back over to MemberSpace, click that sign up link, copy it, and put that here. There we go. Now we have a unique sign up link for our monthly plan and a unique sign up link for our annual plan. There are a couple more things we need to tie together here between Webflow and MemberSpace. Our login button, and remember on our other pages, we have a couple of other things to tie together as well. So let's come back over to MemberSpace. We can close these, and we're gonna come out to customize. From here, we're gonna click on integrations, and then click on Webflow. Here we can now copy this login pop-up that you'll see the login form pops up when clicked, but it turns to your account when logged in for members. So once we have that copied, we'll come back over to Webflow, and this navigation link, we can drop this right here so that they sign in. Then we need to come to our subscribed, make sure this account button has that as sign in, and then come to our previous newsletters and make sure this account button is set with sign in. Now, no matter where members are on the screen, they'll either be able to sign up or log in or access their account information if they are logged in. Great. Now we have everything tied together with MemberSpace and Webflow. So let's come back to our newsletter screen. Once you have all of those pieces connected, you're going to want to go ahead and hit publish so that everything is tied together and updated. Let's go back over to MemberSpace and finish up one more thing before we move on to the next step. So we'll come back out to customize and head to our signup fields. At this screen, you want to hit Add Signup Fields, and here we come to the form. This is a great opportunity to add or collect any additional information from your members as part of the newsletter signup process. So maybe that's a Twitter handle because you want to add them to a Twitter list. Maybe that's something as simple as a privacy policy because you're requiring that as part of the signup. Whatever you would like to collect, now is your opportunity to add it in. As you can see, you have multiple different kinds of input, so you can pick what's applicable here. For this example, let's do a privacy policy. And work down through. So we would like to enable the form field, and here we come to our section of showing it on all member plans, after sign up, or required during. Now you have a couple of options here. If you don't want to require this on all of your member plans, you can toggle that off, but you'll see once you do that, the show field after sign up automatically toggles on. This is standard functionality, so just keep that in mind as you're working through. It's okay with me. We want just this required for the helping creatives, and I do also want it required during sign up. So once you have selected the things that you would like, go ahead and hit add now. From here, you can go back and add as many fields as you would like, but keep in mind, you want the sign up process to be easy for your members. Once you're all done with that, we're gonna go back. You'll be here at this screen, and we're gonna do one last thing back under customize before we move on. The last thing you can do is take a look at the look and feel, and feel free to set this up according to your brand colors, styles, and fonts. So just keep in mind that everything that is highlighted will then change. So you can see the font and font color are for this highlighted area here, and be sure to hit save changes. You can go through each one of these and customize according to your particular brand and styling preferences. Once you have all of that done, we are ready to move on to the final step, which is integrating MailChimp with MemberSpace in Zapier.